budget smartphone segment evolves rapidly with new competition every month. Back in April, I picked up the Redmi Note 4. Here are my opinions on it almost a year after it was launched. Starting off with the design, the phone is gorgeous. The back of the phone is a fingerprint magnet, which I have already mentioned in one of my videos. It's quite photogenic with a very clean design, which makes it very appealing to look at. The front of the phone is no exception. Even though you may only notice it in person, the 2.5D curved glass makes the phone a treat to hold in hand. The bezels are reasonably wide enough for a sub 15k rupee phone, and the phone charges through a micro USB cable, which isn't that much of a great disappointment. As a matter of fact, we might see the next phone in the Note series, the Redmi Note 5, with smaller bezels and a USB-C port, which I am completely stoked for. The Redmi Note 4 has a 4000mAh battery, which gives you about 8 to 10 hours of screen on time. I do not game much on the phone, so I am able to get through 2 days of usage without a single charge. This is humongous, and this is something which is not even present on flagship phones today. On the contrary, charging times on this phone range from 2 to 3 hours, which means that a sudden change of plans will leave your discharged phone at a disadvantage. However, one can also say that the battery makes up for it. The phone's performance is spectacular, as I have never experienced lagging on this device on the stock ROM. It's able to switch between apps easily with them stored in memory due to the 4GB of RAM. It has 64GB of internal storage along with a hybrid SIM slot, so there are very less chances that you would expect storage related problems on the phone. I've tested some heavy games on it and it has no problems handling them without hiccups. MIUI eats up to 2GB of RAM itself, so I'm glad I made the intelligent choice by buying the 4GB version. Every phone has a major flaw, what I like to call the Achilles heel of that smartphone. Here, it's the camera, of course. The images aren't sharp enough, are very noisy, and lack contrast and vibrance. Obviously, you can't really expect good low light performance from a camera, which just crams in the megapixel to impress the average user, even though the images look like straight up potato camera material. Also, people might say that the quality of images depend on the person behind the camera, but for the sake of a review, I'd say that it needs to improve with Xiaomi's upcoming Note phones, which is quite likely after seeing the Mi A1 getting good feedback in the optics department. Lastly, let's come to software. MIUI is solely a hit or miss thing for people, and they might not like that cartoonish appearance, but some may completely ignore it for the simplicity it provides. I reflashed it on my phone just for the review, but I don't even feel the need to install a custom launcher now. I'm a big customization fan, and the way MIUI has totally constrained me from it without forcing me to do so is completely shocking. I'd like to give props to Xiaomi though for constantly providing updates to MIUI to make the user experience and design better and better. In conclusion, the Redmi Note 4 is a great phone. It's fared me well and will continue to do so until I plan on buying a new phone. It's a great phone, gets my job done at the end of the day. It's still not worth buying today even after all of these pros. Why? Because in the smartphone industry today, it's no longer about what's good, it's about what's better. So that's pretty much it for the review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. There's some things that I changed around and which are quite noticeable. I would love to hear your thoughts down in the comments below. I'll catch you all later. Peace.